Skulvig. You were taken from this realm too early.
You who walks among the living, my beloved Gulvig calls to me. She yearns for peace, yet her remains lie in pieces. I beg of
you. You want us to collect
Gulvig's sick?
Really?
Boy.
I can smell you.
Boy, we're...
They've taken three of sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake. Bring her bones, child. Gulvig will reward you.
Ah, good. The special chisel is ahead, past this gate.
Here we go!
Without her spirit.
Father, maybe we should look for those bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom again. If we keep an eye out
look
while we...
Look if you wish, boy. I will not be distracted by this fool's errand. This chisel we seek, what is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Thamur. A very giant giant, who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son, but young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, a quarrel of theirs spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, boom, struck his son. Hrimthur ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son, but in his emotional state, soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night, so far from home. Thor.
And what happened next?
You'll see.
Thor killed him. I know. He fell in the village?
Aye. When Thamur fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. The truth is, the sweaty ball bag just got lucky.
A Wolver!
A dangerous beast. We will take him down together. Focus up, boy!
Tip of one, yes. Very, very giant. Magically sealed, I'm afraid. Neat trick, lad.
Thanks. Nice idea. What happened to the survivors?
Oh, Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything.
This is locked up good.
Follow me, Atreus.
Find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
Enemies. Right behind you. Wolver, left side.
Yeah.
increase that. Well, here's the base for the crystal we saw. But how do we get it down?
Yasta!
Can you read it?
Yes, sir. To Njord, we offer back the seas.
Ah, yes. It was believed that Njord calmed the winds and seas for the fishermen. For that, they loved and worshipped him here.
What's through here? How are we getting down there?
I have a plan.
You do?
Do not act so surprised.
Oh, no offense, brother, but I don't even think Thor with Mjolnir in hand could get through that much ice.
Then Thor is a fool.
This should be entertaining.
Boy.
Right.
On your left! Incoming fire!
That was, something, that fight. Here, catch. Well, that was a waste of a perfectly good hour.
How were you not seen? There is nowhere here to hide.
Oh, that. It's a little trick my people can pull. A special way of not being seen.
You can be invisible?
More like I can step into the realm between realms. And your mind doesn't understand what it's seeing, so... it sees nothing at all. That's how we avoid ever having to actually use the weapons we craft. It doesn't seem to work on dragons, though.
Your brother wanted to know if you're getting enough to eat. I guess I could tell him you are.
Brock was asking about me?
Was there meat on his breath?
You let him touch this again. Come on, then.
So that's how Brock was in the temple right after the water drop. He stepped between realms.
Okay, now, shush. I need complete silence for this. There you go. What speaks to you? What can I do for you? And we're back to you. What a surprise. Wear it in good health. Don't let the Draugr get you. Let's do it. Ah, isn't that neat? Now don't be a stranger! I'm feeling creative today. Well, scrounge around a bit more and we'll build something then.
Can you guess it?
Knowing you, it doesn't involve standing around here.
Correct.
But how do we move forward? Boy, Armor really liked jewelry, didn't he? Even braided his beard with it.
I happen to think he looks dashing. You know, for a snow-covered corpse.
Right here!